Hey there, friends. Foster the Canadian here, bringing you another Fridays with Foster, a weekly series in which you ask me questions that I answer, you tell me stories that I share with everyone, and you ask me advice, and I try to do my best in giving out advice. Now, remember that Fridays with Foster is 100% anonymous. I don't give out any names, and I do that because I don't want to shine a spotlight on you guys. I'm sure if you've seen the other episodes, you've heard me say this 100 times already. So, without any further ado, actually, there is one thing, there's a little more ado. The gameplay. This is not me playing my best, but the reason I picked it is because it was a close game right until about the end, and I figured that that might make for better footage than just me, you know, totally destroying, going 30-2 or whatever. I think I did alright, maybe like 23-9, 23-10, which, you know, not my best game, but the fact that it was so close, I think, makes it worth this video. So let's get on to the first story. Alright, this first story I'd like to call Wedding Night Nerves. I want to start off by saying I am not a subscriber, but I watched all of your recent episodes of Fridays with Foster and really enjoyed them. I have a problem that I cannot stop thinking about, and I don't want to ask anyone that I know personally, so I am coming to you. I am 23 years old, and I am about to get married. The problem I have is that I'm a virgin, and my fiance is not. That isn't the real issue, though. I am worried that our first night together, I won't be good enough for her and embarrass myself. I figure since she has experience and I don't, that I should get some with someone else before our night. I don't want to start off our marriage with a horrible night in bed, and I would also feel bad about having to lie to her about something like this so soon in our marriage. Any help would be great, and please make sure that I am anonymous. Alright, first off, everyone is anonymous. Every single person on Fridays with Foster, aside from the very first story, which was a close friend of mine who gave me permission to use his name, is anonymous, so you never have to worry about that. Now, you started off by saying that you're not a subscriber, and it didn't start off on the best note, and it just went downhill from there. I don't want to seem angry at anyone that sends in a message, but come on, dude. You're 23 years old, you're about to get married, and you ask me if you should cheat on your fiancé. What kind of answer do you expect me to give you? No, a resounding no, and here's why. I'm not just going to throw it out there, no. What do you think matters more to her? The fact that you were great in bed on your first night, you were a total stud, or the fact that she was the first person you were with? That kind of sentiment goes a long way, a lot further than any great night in bed. Now, you're looking at this from a really weird perspective. I'm not exactly sure how you got here, but I'm going to tell you right now. If you do go out and you cheat on her so that you're good in bed, if she finds out, and she likely will, that's not something that you can hide for very long, she will be pissed. Now, something is really special about sharing yourself with someone for the first time, and I guarantee you that's what she wants way more than a great first night. Women are all about sentiment, and there is possibly nothing more sentimental than that. So that's my advice. Don't cheat on your fiance. I can't believe I have to say that. But yeah, don't cheat on your fiance. And I guarantee you, regardless of how you perform, it's going to be a very special, very romantic night, and it's going to be one that she treasures regardless of how good you are. So I hope that helps. Alright, now this next one marks the first ever response from Fridays with Foster. So, let's start it off. Hey, I was in the first Fridays with Foster. If you don't remember me, I was someone who needed help with my girlfriend who did drugs. When I confronted her, like you said, kindly and calmly, she broke down in tears. She told me that she had experimented with different types of drugs and was now hooked. I went to my parents after that and told them what happened, and how I needed them to help me to help her. They contacted her parents, and we all got together to help. She wasn't mad that I went behind her back to tell my parents, and I was afraid she would be. She was surprised at how no one was mad at her, and that she now had 7 people who wanted to help her. Me, my parents, her brother, and her sister. She's getting a lot of help now and hasn't done anything since. I was scared at this situation, so I wanted to thank you for reaching out to me when I needed some insight. Once again, thanks. Keep up the good work. P.S. Where are the Skyrim vids? More! Alright, I guess I should start off with the Skyrim videos. They will be coming out soon, don't worry. I just have had some trouble with my power going out, the storm and everything. But they're going to be back pretty soon. Now let's get back to your message. Now you said, I reached out to you and that couldn't be further from the truth. You did the work here reaching out to me. You needed help and all I did was provide you with, you know, as you said, some insight. And I'm really glad it worked out the way it did. And the reason I picked this isn't just because it is the first response video for Fridays with Foster, which alone is something really cool, but I want to show you guys that, you know, it can feel like a really lonely world when you're a teenager and you know, you have to deal with this kind of stuff that you really shouldn't have to deal with at this age. Always have someone to reach out to. No matter who it is, you know, in this case it was a YouTuber that told him to reach out to parents or a counselor, and it seems like it's working so far. And I just wanted to let you guys know that no matter what kind of trouble you get yourselves into or someone else is in, you can always reach out. There's always going to be a hand out there to help you. I just thought that I'd put this in here because it's something that more people need to know about. So I'm really glad that I could help you in any way that I did. And I'm glad you're enjoying the Skyrim videos. Let me know if this works out further down the line. Alright, and this final story I'd like to call Chicken Sandwich with a Side of Crazy. This is a story of the time my friend and I were chased by a crazy man. Now, being small children, my friend and I would do silly things, and one thing we took particular pleasure in was walking to a neighbor's gated house and speaking into an intercom he had there and saying silly things. Now, on this day in particular, we decided to order food. McDonald's in particular. Once I finished ordering my third chicken sandwich, the man began screaming at us incoherently, and then we saw his gate begin to open, and he slammed open his front door, and my friend and I bolted. We were only a couple hundred feet from school, however, and being small children, we quickly outran the man and made it to school. To this day, I wonder if he intended to kill us or just wanted to give us our order. Well, the thing that I find interesting about this is he screamed at you incoherently. Isn't that basically what happens when you order at McDonald's? Through the intercom, you just hear screaming incoherently. The one thing that I took from this is don't just start ordering chicken sandwiches from crazy people's houses. I remember I had this neighbor once who was, he wasn't like a bad guy, I don't think, at least, but I kept playing Ding Dong Ditch'em or whatever that game is where you ring the door and you run away. And I remember I did that once, and we'd always run to the bush that was like behind his house, and or you know, to the side of his house so he couldn't see us. And he ran out the door one day and he looked around, and I'm like, you know, oh god, he's gonna find me. And I hear him going, "That better be a damn dog in the bush." And at that point, I could have crapped my pants. I was so terrified. I look up. This is the frailest little man I'd ever seen. Like, he was maybe 80 pounds with shoes on. And he wasn't, like, short. He was average height, just the tiniest old man. And I felt so bad that all this time I was pulling pranks on such a frail old man. And, you know, that is just one of those things that I took away as a kid. Like, I should stop doing this. I don't want to tick off anyone that I feel bad about. But, in your case, you know, it sounds like he had it coming if he was a crazy person. Alright, I hope you guys enjoyed this week's Fridays with Foster. And if you want to submit a story of your own, Just send me a YouTube message. I'll take stories, questions. I'll answer advice. So if you have any questions, you need any advice, any stories of absolute terror or epic greatness, anything, you know, send it my way. I'll make sure that it's 100% anonymous. Again, I can't stress that enough. And you can end up in next week's Fridays with Foster. And if you did enjoy this week's Fridays with Foster, maybe it deserved a like. And if you really enjoyed it, you can check out last week's Fridays with Foster in the annotation right here. It was it was a pretty good episode. Throwdown at the mall and girl advice. Took my hand at giving away some girl advice, which, some mixed results, I think. But overall, you know, it's up to you guys to decide if it was good advice or not. And, so I hope you guys enjoyed. Until next time, this is Foster the Canadian, saying see ya.